It certainly wasn't meant to end this way. Ricky Ponting's illustrious career concludes with a South African annihilation. Ten's Lockie Reed's in Perth. Lockie, the Proteas certainly carved Australia up in the series deciding test.
Yes, Brad, a very disappointing way to send off a true champion of Australian cricket in Ricky Ponting. The Aussies smashed inside 4 days at the Wacca. South Africa winning by a total of 309 runs and wrapping up the series 1-0. Ponting made 8. The pick of the batsman was Mitchell Starc. He actually scored 68 off 43 balls. His 50 was the second fastest by an Australian ever.
Mission improbable.
Oh, gone. Second ball of the morning.
Turned mission impossible.
Ouch, yes, beautiful bowling.
The stage was set for Ricky Ponting.
Wonderful ovations. South Africans giving him a guard of honour.
Spine-tingling sportsmanship, appreciation for a truly magnificent career.
Graham's gesture and the South African boys' gesture was, that sort of stuff will remain with me forever, and I told him that on the field today.
With a signature flash of willow,
the Ponting of yesteryear.
Hopes of a fairy tale flourished. It wasn't to be.
He's edged it.
Lumps in throats, the sporting world farewelled one of the greatest.
17 years of blood, sweat and toil.
The end of an era brought a tear to the eye. So did this.
Got a feeling that's around the region where everyone else thinks it's funny bar you.
Lofty, lower order hitting.
Oh, that's got to be big. Oh, really big.
Delayed the inevitable.
Edge and taken.
The world's best. Proving just that.
I certainly will have a really warm feeling that I've been a part of something really incredible and special.
Emotional scenes as Ricky's wife Rihanna, daughters Matisse and Emmy paid tribute to a husband and father.
Given up a lot to let me try and achieve the things that I've achieved in this game. So without them, it wouldn't have happened.
A nation salutes Ricky Ponting for 17 years proudly wearing baggy green.
Hopefully my impact and input on Australian cricket has left some behind, so thank you.
Liam Cox, 10 News.
Michael Clarke was named the player of the series, and the Aussies have little time to wallow in their pity. They've got another test series coming up, this time against Sri Lanka. It starts on December 14. Brad?
Hopefully we win that one. Terrific. Thanks to Lockie Reed in Perth. The Israel Folau soap opera is set to conclude tomorrow, with the New South Wales Waratahs expected to unveil Folau as their latest recruit at a media conference in the morning. The Super Rugby franchise will reportedly fork out a third of its salary cap on a one-year deal rumoured to be worth $1.5 million. The move to union would complete a trifecta of football codes for the 23-year-old who left the AFL, we were told, to return to the NRL, only for the deal to fall over. Tonight is usually the night we celebrate the best in Australian tennis, but an all too familiar script has unfolded with another Bernard Tomic controversy stealing the limelight. Jackie Reed is in Melbourne with the story.
Thanks, Brad. Well, I'm here at the third annual John Newcombe Medal Night, and there's plenty of tennis royalty here, but there is one noticeable absentee. Bernard Tomic hasn't turned up tonight. He's declined his invitation, and it's not a good look for the 20-year-old. He's had a disappointing season on the court and off the court. He's had more than his fair share of headlines, and that continued yesterday when he was seen on the Gold Coast cruising the streets in a bright yellow Ferrari. His new wheels have impressed his Davis Cup captain, Pat Rafter.
Oh, it looked like a nice car he had. So, I don't blame him if he wants to drive around. He knows what he needs to do, is whether it's up to him whether or not he wants to do it, because no one else can push him except himself.
Bernie probably hasn't had the year that he would like to have had. And, it's sometimes a wake-up call for young players like that, and they realise that it's not going to just happen.
Yeah, it's no big deal. I couldn't make it a couple of years ago as well, so everyone's got things on, and I'm sure he's still trying to prepare for the Australian summer as well as anything.
It is a little bit disappointing. Obviously, he's got his own troubles that he's trying to deal with at the moment, so we'll leave him to do with that, but we'll certainly get on with it.
But tonight is all about the John Newcombe Medal. Sam Stoza, Marinko Matosevic, Leighton Hewitt and Casey Delacqua all in the running. But as expected, hot favourite Sam Stoza took it out for a third consecutive year. Brad.
Yeah, deserving winner. Terrific. Thanks very much to Jackie. V8 Supercar champion Jamie Whincup is struggling to come to terms with being labelled one of the sport's all-time greats. The 29-year-old equaled legends Bob Jane, Alan Moffat and Jim Richards by becoming a four-time series winner, but he says he tries not to focus on records.
At the moment, the numbers don't mean anything to me, but I know in 20 years' time when I'm telling my grandkids how good I was, I'm sure that'll mean everything.
Whincup expects retired MotoGP rider Casey Stoner to line up in next year's V8 Supercar Development Series with 888 Racing.
Of mine for next year.
Northern Irishman Graham McDowell ended a two-year drought when he won Tiger Woods Golf Tournament, the World Challenge in California. Woods, looking a little hipper than usual, struggled for momentum during his final round. Finishing in a tie for fourth, he was 8 shots off McDowell, who finished 17 under.
What a shot.
Martin Keimer also secured an overdue victory, winning the Sun City event in South Africa. But once again, it was the local wildlife which stole the show on the final day. This baby baboon, a standout, although it all got a bit hectic, as it does for baby baboons, and a nap was required. On the back nine, where's your... Play of the day, and it's time to pull on your skates for the Ice Cross Downhill World Champs at Niagara Falls. More than 35,000 fans lined the course to see defending champ Kyle Croxall in the white jersey crash midway through the race before coming back to take the lead. The Canadian favourite with lightning fast footwork skates his way onto the top of the podium. And into our play of the day. We love animals coming onto a golf course, don't we?
We do.
You see a lot of kangaroos at the PGA at Coolum.
We've got a bizarre fascination with rogue animals on a golf course. But I'm glad you bring them to us as part of your sport broadcast.
Thanks,
thank you very much, Brad.